I'm sharing four real-life examples of how bloggers make money, including how I made nearly $15,000 last month. I'll not only reveal how four bloggers make six-figure incomes, but four tips you can use to make money even on a small blog. We're talking how much you can make blogging today on Let's Talk Money.
Beat that.
Make money.
Make your money work for you.
Creating the financial future you deserve.
Let's Talk Money.
Joseph Hogue with the Let's Talk Money channel here on YouTube. I want to send a special shout-out to everyone in the community. Thank you for taking a part of your day to be here. If you're not part of that community yet, just click that little red subscribe button. It's free and you'll never miss an episode. I've helped 97 people start a blog. Now that's just the ones I've helped directly through a special discount I negotiated with Bluehost, not counting the 100,000 plus that watch the videos or read the blog each month. And if there's one question I get most from these new bloggers, it's how much money can you make with a small blog? Now you see, so many bloggers get started after seeing monthly income reports from huge established bloggers. Then they live that ultimate frustration every small blogger faces. The despair of spending hours a week writing a blog post that nobody's going to read, and that frustration from not making as much money as you thought you would. I was there in 2013 when I started my blogs, and I've seen hundreds of bloggers fight through this. So I want to help you get started, just like those others that I've helped, by sharing four real-life examples of how bloggers are making money, and then four tips to make money even on a smaller blog. We'll start with those four blogger income examples, but stick around because I'm going to be revealing four ways to make money blogging on any size website. Now, Kayla Sloan started her website in 2014, but didn't switch to full-time blogging until late 2015. Now, she gets just 7,000 page views a month, but it's a great example of how bloggers can still make money even on a smaller site. Now, Kayla started freelance writing and then started teaching others to write online and make more money. This is one of the most common career paths I see with bloggers, and it's similar to how I started. Kayla now makes over $11,000 a month and focuses mostly on her students now instead of writing. Freelance writing pays off immediately, and as long as you have a decent command of the English language, you can easily make $30 an hour and more. You do this while your own blog grows, and eventually you're making so much from your own site that you don't have to freelance anymore. The message here is get started with a blog and use some of the income sources that I'll reveal later. Some are going to provide that immediate payout, while others take longer to build but mean more money over the long run. So Lena of the site What Mommy Does gets a mountain of traffic with over 350,000 views a month, but I wanted to highlight it here because I think her strategy works even for smaller bloggers. Now Lena reports four income sources: affiliate marketing, advertising, sponsored posts, and an ebook, and she consistently makes around 10 grand a month from all these. Now this is a pretty typical blogger income report, and the core income sources that you're going to use to make money at first. Your first check is probably going to come from ads on the site, but make a plan from day one to get those sponsored posts and the affiliate payouts. Now, Lena didn't start with this huge blog. She had less than 20,000 visitors in January 2015, but built it into a legit online business. Like any business, blogging is a long game, and the ones that put in the time are the ones that build their income into that six-figure payday. Two more examples of how much bloggers make, and then those four tips to make more money, but I want to get your feedback on this one. How much do you want to make each month, whether it's from a blog or other online assets? How much do you want to make, and what are some of the ideas in this video that are going to help you do that? So this one is just as much about getting your feedback as it is getting you to think, how can this work for me? How can I apply this to reach that income goal? So scroll down and let me know in the comments. Now, Carrie Smith Nicholson of Careful Sense has a fairly small blog, but she's managed to turn it into a legit work from home business. Now, Carrie makes a good chunk of her blogging income from digital product sales. And that's just things like downloadable planners or printables that can be anything from a one-page checklist to a mini ebook. Now, this is for 3 months, but she didn't include her freelancing income here. So adding that means she made just over $6,700 a month for the quarter. Look at these individual income sources though. What I like here is that you see no one income source is usually going to make a blogger rich. Carrie made about $4,000 a month freelancing and $1,000 a month on digital products, but none of these were huge by themselves. A few bloggers make enough from just one income source to focus on just that one. Put five or six of these sources together though, and you've got a solid income. Now, I started tracking my own blogging income in April 2015 and made an earth-shattering $60 that month. By the end of the year though, I was making around $2,000 a month and have grown the business to six figures since. In nearly 5 years, I've made over $281,000 on the blogs and the YouTube channel, and I grow my income every single year. In the 8 months through August, I've averaged almost $11,000 a month from six sources, a 54% increase from the last year and hit a record 14,813 last month. Now, this is off four blogs I still own, all within that personal finance space and this YouTube channel. So yeah, I stay pretty busy, but make good money doing it. I regularly make money through six income sources, including books, Amazon affiliates, courses, ads here on YouTube, affiliate marketing and sponsorships. And those of you in the community will notice something here. The income from any single source can vary a lot from month to month. Now, I was making a couple thousand each month earlier this year on courses during those launches and when I was really promoting them, but that's dried up though over this last month. I was still able to reach a new record though on total income because a few of these other sources really stepped up. That's a big lesson here in blogging. You need to go after several of these income sources that we'll talk about next just to really balance out your income from month to month. Now I want to share four tips that will help you make money even on a smaller blog. Four rules that are going to help you make money starting today on your blog. First is you can't wait for traffic to start making money. Okay, I die a little every time I hear someone say they're waiting to grow their blog before they worry about making money. If you have one person reading your blog or watching your YouTube channel, you can make money. Have a product plan from day one, whether that means which ebooks you want to produce or maybe some quick printables that you can sell through the blog. Start thinking about those digital products that you can sell. Rule number two here is just to learn the different ways that bloggers use to make money and then to build in as many of those as possible. Now, in each of those blogger income examples above, you saw all the reasons for using multiple income sources. From smoothing out your monthly income to just making more money, you need to be balancing as many of these income sources as possible. They say that the average millionaire is collecting an income off seven different sources, and it's no different for bloggers. Next here is to blend affiliate marketing and self-publishing into your content strategy. Now, this means every week or every month, whenever you sit down to think about what you might write about on your blog or on your YouTube channel, include affiliates and self-publishing in that mix. For affiliates, this means finding the ones that are going to work to really help your readers, then planning on doing a review post or a comparison article each month. This is going to build up a library of content that's going to start getting traffic from Google every single month and start making you passive income even when you stop posting. For self-publishing, building this income source into your content strategy just means deciding on a book that you want to publish. And then you outline the chapters and write one a week to post on your blog. This makes it so you have something to post on your blog, but also gets your book finished without having to spend twice the time. Our fourth rule for making money is going to be more indirect, but it's going to come out over the long run. Create a plan to increase your blog traffic with search engine optimization, or SEO. Now, I know I just showed you that you can make money on a small blog, but the truth is that it's always going to be those bigger blogs that make more money. You'll make more money from almost every source, including sponsors, affiliates, and your own products. Now, I've got quite a few videos here on the channel to help you get started blogging and make more money, so I'll link to those in the video description below. Click on the video to the right here for a free 5-video series on everything you need to start blogging. From getting your website up to easy writing tips and growing traffic, you'll find it all in these 5 videos. Don't forget to join the Let's Talk Money community by tapping that subscribe button and clicking the bell notification.